Good morning, moms. It's Monday. Yay! I love Mondays. Triggers. What are your triggers? This is Michelle Weidenbender, your chief hope builder. You can change your life if you focus on one word at a time. And today's word is triggers. Just like our addicted loved ones have triggers, so do we. Yeah. We're human, right? And here's the thing. I'm going to talk about triggers, but I want you to know that it's basic humanness to want to get our needs met, right? So I don't judge anybody for not being peaceful all the time, because in this body of ours, we look to find peace through getting our needs met, our self-care, right? Well, here's the thing. Sometimes we fall short. Everybody does. But I want to talk to you about boundaries for just a second. Here are some of the triggers that you might have. And before we can help ourselves learn how to handle boundaries differently, we have to be aware of what is going on. And so here are just some warning signs, maybe some of your triggers. If you feel responsible for other people's thoughts, feelings, or needs, you feel like that's your job, or you feel like maybe your husband or somebody you love or loves you is responsible for understanding what you need and how to be there for you and know what you're feeling and thinking and all that, you might have a boundary problem. If you find yourself angry and short-tempered, you might have a boundary problem. And for instance, if you do things like for your addicted loved one, your spouse, your grandkids, and you just hate it because you feel like people are always walking all over you and taking advantage of you and you don't feel appreciated, you probably have a boundary problem. And you rarely stand up for yourself. Not that you are falling short. It's just we have to guard our self-care, right? And so if you notice these things where you're just resenting other people, your job, your kids, your anything, we can change that about ourselves, right? But we have to be aware first. So ask yourself, how am I feeling today? How am I feeling in this moment? And if you find yourself just angry, you know, really do a self-check. What is it? Has somebody done something? I heard this lady yesterday complaining that she kept being invited into these personal texting groups. And she would ask them, please take me out of this group. And they just kept violating that, right? And I said, you know, you'll have to do something more because it's a boundary. And it was really bothering her. And I get it. She said, you know, her phone was blowing up with like 70 text messages. Who wants that, right? And sometimes we feel like, well, if we say something, we're going to hurt somebody's feelings. We're not in charge of other people's feelings. We're in charge of our own feelings and getting our needs met, yes, but not with anger, resentment, or manipulation. So what are your triggers? Start paying attention to that, because if you pay attention to your triggers, you will learn something about yourself. And maybe you'll discover that you're having problems setting boundaries. And I'm here to say again, I'm not going to judge you, but just start on your boundary journey to learn more about how you can be assertive in a loving way without feeling guilty. And know this, once you set a boundary, especially with your addicted loved one, if it's a new boundary, oh, Yeah, there's going to be some discomfort in that, and there's going to be some backlash with that, and expect it, okay? But it's going to be much easier to deal with that than a lifetime of resentment. You know, once we can learn how to let that go and be uncomfortable for a little while, it's going to pay off in good returns, because we're going to be able to get all that stress off of our chest and realize that, oh, I am in control and I can have a loving relationship even if I set boundaries. So this is Michelle with Monday Matters, and I am praying that today and this week you can focus on your triggers and try to understand where those are coming from and how you can get in control of, you know, just finding peace. Okay? God bless.